Greetings, everyone. Sulfur is one of the most common minerals found in the human body. It fights the bacteria that causes acne, so one could only guess what would happen if you went without it. From chronic fatigue to obesity to cardiovascular disease, there are many symptoms of sulfur deficiency. In this video, we'll talk about all of them. Let's begin. Number 1. Memory loss. While it's not the most common problem, it's one of the most harmful. You see, sulfur is responsible for reducing the death of hippocampal cells. This ensures that your brain retains most of the information. As you age, the hippocampal cells start to degrade. If you're consuming foods that are already rich in sulfur, you don't really have to worry. Sulfur will protect those cells and enable you to remember most of the things. We can't say the same if you don't have enough sulfur in your diet. Without sulfur, there'll be nothing left in your body to stop the hippocampal cells from dying. This causes memory loss. Many patients with Alzheimer's disease usually have very low levels of sulfur in their body. Another study also shows that consuming more foods with sulfur proves to be beneficial for patients with Alzheimer's. Don't worry though, it's not hard to get your daily dose of sulfur. Just add some broccoli, kale, and cabbage to your diet. If those foods don't interest you, go for sulfur supplements. Number 2. Depression. This is where sulfur is involved, but not directly. One of your body's most powerful antioxidants is cysteine. It's actually a sulfur-based amino acid that helps to stabilize the mood. Even in a study, it was found that N-acetylcysteine, sound it out, helps deal with depression that comes with other mental disorders. In case you were wondering, N-acetylcysteine is also one type of cysteine. It's a variant of the same type of sulfur-based amino acid. Now imagine this biochemical function without sulfur. What could happen? Well, your body could be in depression because of stress and other disorders. Your brain won't be able to release the N-acetylcysteine because there won't be enough sulfur to create it. It would have to compensate with other feel-good chemicals. That other feel-good chemical may not be as good as N-acetylcysteine, so make sure your body has enough sulfur so your body can help your brain deal with this depression. Are you liking this video so far? Hit subscribe and click that notification bell to stay updated on all of our latest Bestie content. Moving on. Number 3. Obesity. This is a health issue that's getting more serious by the day. What if we told you that sulfur deficiency plays an important role in obesity? We've already spoken about cysteine. There's another amino acid just like cysteine. We're all talking about methionine. Both these amino acids fulfill their respective roles in the daily biochemical functions of our body. After your body ingests food, it gets synthesized. All the nutrients become absorbed. This process is assisted by methionine. When there's a lack of sulfur, there's also a lack of methionine. As a result, there's nothing to synthesize. Whatever you eat will get segregated, and a lot of that food will be converted into fat. If you don't want this to happen, make sure to consume your share of sulfur. You can also try losing weight. Which reminds me about the video we did on genetic research and its relation to weight loss. If you haven't seen it yet, please take a look. Number 4. Cardiovascular disease. Your heart is an organ that never stops working. This is one of the reasons why you need to take care of it. One of the major causes of getting cardiovascular problems is a spike in your cholesterol levels. Now you might be wondering, hang on, this is supposed to be about sulfur. Why are you talking about cholesterol? Well, we're glad you asked. You see, sulfur plays a vital role in managing your cholesterol levels. Imagine this, you may have a dog at home that you love a lot. Now the dog is not always the most well-behaved. Sometimes he gets distracted and wanders off on his own. This is why you put a leash or a collar on him. Sulfur is that leash or collar that helps to keep cholesterol in check. So, you can imagine what would happen if sulfur's absent. Even in a study, it was found that patients with heart problems usually have low levels of sulfur in their body. You can always avoid this by consuming more eggs, beans, and other sulfur-rich foods. Also, make sure to get enough sunlight. It's a good source of vitamin D. Number 5. Chronic fatigue syndrome. Sulfur is usually abundant in foods that are high in protein. For this reason, it's highly unlikely that you'd get this deficiency. So if you still manage to get it, it could mean that you aren't having enough protein. Now, here's the problems with that. Without protein, your body won't have the means to strengthen your muscles and bones. It won't be able to burn fat the way it should. More importantly, you won't have the right amount of energy that you require. Do you remember the two amino acids in sulfur, cysteine and methionine? They help your body absorb the protein properly. Without both protein and these acids, your body gets weaker. When this condition continues, you get something called chronic fatigue syndrome. As the name suggests, this condition causes you to feel exhausted all the time. You can try resting when you feel tired, but it's not gonna go away. It'll stick with you. We also did a video explaining the reasons why you always feel tired. Check it out if you haven't done so. Number 6, toxins in your liver. It's neither your heart nor your brain that suffers the most when you're sulfur deficient. It's actually the liver. If your body doesn't have enough sulfur, the liver can't excrete toxic particles properly. As a result, they'll get stuck in your liver, giving you gut-related problems. Even in a study, it was observed that people who didn't have enough sulfur complained more about digestive problems than those who added sulfur to their diet. Keep in mind that your liver needs to function properly in order for you to stay healthy. An unhealthy liver can lead to major infections and other problems in your gut. Moving on. Number 7, problems in cell function. Your cells need sulfur in order to function. This is mainly because sulfur is one of the most necessary ingredients in the structure of a cell. Without it, it would be impossible for a cell to maintain itself. That's not all though. Lack of sulfur also could mean that your cells won't be getting the sufficient amount of oxygen they need through respiration. For this reason, they may get damaged and die. This includes the cells in all parts of your body. Even the ones in your brain need sulfur to sustain themselves. Of course, cell damage or death is more of a possibility if you're very low in sulfur. As long as you're maintaining a good diet with sulfur, you won't have to worry at all. While it is important to have sulfur, there is also a condition that doesn't allow you to consume sulfur. Sulfur intolerance. Did you know about this? Let's flip the script for a moment. Sulfur intolerance is a condition where your body's too sensitive to sulfur and sulfites. In such a case, the person may not be able to digest food that has sulfur in it. Unfortunately, a lot of research still needs to be done on this condition. We know one thing for sure. It's a rather rare condition, as only 1 out of 100 people are affected by it. If you're one of them, then maybe you should avoid it or at least lower your intake. So, do you have a sulfur deficiency? Do you know anyone that may have it? Have you added enough sulfur to your diet? Let us know in the comment section below. We'd love to hear from you. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait! What kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.